Well, I'm going home, so let us start. I'd like to address myself to the family of the late PO3 Darwin Espilardo, the wife, si Cleofi, si Dwendel, Vice Mayor, Vice Admiral rather, Cesar Takad, the Flag Officer in Command of the Philippine Navy, FOIC, the officials, men and women of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, the media, the beautiful media of the Philippines, my countrymen. I just landed dyan sa Villamor. But I thought that yung kadaber na sa bahay na, or sa dito lang pala, ilibing rin. So I'm... Salamat po. Sino kani pangalan mo, ma? I'm also flying to Cotabato to see the wounded soldiers and two casualties of that incident. Sometimes we lose, sometimes we gain. In Basilan, we scored a crucial victory by capturing a stronghold somewhere in the hinterlands of Basilan. In other fronts, it's really a war. I said we win some battles, we lose in other skirmishes, but definitely we are willing to win the war. Government is not without resources, not without a human bodies there fighting for this republic on so many fronts, but there's a new front which is deadly and one which is coming up. The one presently wreaking havoc on the lives of the people of this nation is drug. And then we have the insurrection in Mindanao, the MIMNN, and of course the criminal elements of the Abu Sayyaf. We continue to talk, and we hope some progress on the front between the Communist Party of the Philippines and the government. And we are about to begin our talks in Mindanao with the MI and MN. There is no use of capturing anybody there on the rebel fronts. We do not intend to serve warrants there, except against criminals. But for the revolutionaries, Ms. Wari can any time, if he's ready to talk with us, can just call us or any general thereabout in Sulu, and my orders would really be just to escort him or wherever he wants to go. I would suggest that we hold talks in Mindanao because it would be convenient for everybody, including the MI. And if you can hold it simultaneous, anyway, iba-ibang tao naman ang kausapin yan along the stages of the negotiation. So somehow I think we can hack it. We have the time. We just, as I said, a soft landing for everybody. No recriminations at this time. No hostile attitude, no antagonistic statements. We remain hopeful, and I pray, I hope and pray to God that we would be successful in this, because it is really a matter of a choice between retaining the war and passing on to the next generation just around the corner, or we talk peace and realize a productive and fruitful land and generation in Mindanao. The drug problem, just like the Abu Sayyaf, must be crushed, destroyed. I don't care how it is destroyed, it must be destroyed. Let me correct some grave misconception about the United Nations coming in to investigate genocide. That's a very stupid statement. The United Nations does not have any business investigating human rights violations of the police. I just don't want to be an insulting, you know, you don't come here and investigate the deaths of criminals. And those suspected, sabi nila, na pinatay ng police, when after all, we have also lost a sizable amount of our population dito sa security forces and government. Bakit ka mag-imbestiga dito ng criminal? Samantalang sa Middle East and in other parts of the world, they're killing men, women, and children, bombing hospitals. And yet, I do not hear this. Gainit na ang ulo ko, so may I just drink water to your success. For those killed by the police in encounters, wala problema. And as a matter of fact, I have ordered an investigation for every killing and every encounter that results in an encounter, a bloody encounter. Alam mo, ang police kasi, kung may hulihin, hindi naglalakad yung mag-isa. I mean, they just go about patrolling and apprehending people into drugs or connected with drugs and to die there. They go in groups. Naturalmente, pagsabi niya sa, ang problema kasi ang, they think it's a one-on-one. You know, they go by about 3-4. At pag nagkamali yung, pwede patayin mo. Pagka lumaban, yun ang, now, for those who are killed by rival, alam mo, ang nangyari kasi sa kanila, to save themselves, tinuturo nila yung iba, they feed the government with wrong information, ituturo nila yung iba para sila maka-escapo, or the protectors who are policemen also, feeding the information there at gagantian kasi sabihin na sinong nagpiyak sa kanila and they go an deadly internecine. Bakit pa ang police maghabol? If I were to order the police, why would you waste your time? Puta, masipa kita. Bakit balutin mo pa? Tapos di isang bala na lang. Tapos, iwanan mo. Why do you have to kill him and carry him somewhere else? Unless the killing is not legal. But ang lahat naman ng encuentro, tinitignan ko, yung encuentro talaga, for those who are murdered by other people, ang hindi kasi nasilip ng Pilipino, maraming mga may armas sa serbisyo sa ibang lugar, tapos they serve their country, sacrificing their lives, ang mga anak nila dito na iwan, nalulong sa droga o pinapatay ng mga addict. So that happens. And if I were the father, if I were a citizen of this republic, and my daughter gets raped because of an addict, she's killed. Putang ina mo, papatayin talaga kita. Huwag kang umasa ang buhayin kita pagdating ko. I won't take that shit. Ganon. Simple as that. Others are murdered without any rhyme or reason. There has to be a reason to kill a human being. So money, perfidy, yung piyaitan na walang turo dito, turo doon. Siyempre, pag ipinagbili mong itong isa, magagalit talaga isa. Pag naipit itong isa, sabihin mo siya, huwag mo akong huliin, mas may malaki sa akin. Yan. Hindi lang kami basta papatay na papatay dyan. Bakit ko patayin sa Cavite tapos itapon ko sa Bulacan? You must be stupid. Pag-addict yan, enkwentruhin mo, patayin mo. And I'd rather to see a dead. I do not want to see a government So kaya dito, nag-grade ng nag-grade sila warrant. O see? How many died? 3. Yan pa ba? Baka gusto na lang i-complain yan sa kami magko-complain din sa human rights. They got about 8 who died, so I have about 6, 7, I don't know if it's 3 or 4. So I have to go to Cotabato to visit the wounded. Expenses of government, yan. You know, drugs is a health problem. 600,000 plus is 600,000 plus. Half of them, or almost a third of them, are already beyond rehabilitation because by the constant use of shabu, your brain will shrink and it cannot be floated back to its original size because it is destroyed by a deadly mix of chemicals. Mas mabuti pa yung cocaine, pati yung heroin, because they are cultivated or made from a grown organic plant called the poppy. Poppy yung opium. Hindi masyado yan. Ito, alam ba ninyo yung tubig na ginagamit niya? Putang inang sabon na yan, tubig ng baterya. It's acid. Kaya pag tinama ang utak mo, it destroys a lot of molecules there. And when it is shrunk, it stays shrunk. Hindi mo pwedeng dalhin yan doon sa vulcanizing plant. Lagay mo yung tainga na para lumaki uli. I am fighting not an epidemic, it's a pandemic. When you reach something like 600,000, hundreds of thousands of Filipinos, these guys must be crazy. Here's one crusading lady who's even herself led a very immoral life, taking his driver as her lover. And, you know, I'm not sure now. I have to, yung lahat ng ATM ng, ano, intercept. Napunta sa driver niya. Paramour niya ang driver niya. Ginawaan niya ng bahay. At ngayon, yung driver niya naging hook rin sa drugs because of the close association. But we are sure that he received a huge money, amount of money. I am not sure kung yun ang ginastos nitong gagang ito sa election. Sino pa bang iba? You know, when you are an immoral, dirty woman. The driver was married. So if you live with the driver, it's concubinage. In the olden times, there is no distinction between man and a woman. It's all together, just plain adultery. You occupy a high position, tapos paano ano ganyan. Let me ask her, what is the name of your driver? At bakit may malaking bahay yan? Can he afford it? Who made it for him? You might want an answer, or you might give us an answer, because driver mo, lover mo. Tapos you have the goal asking people about bullshit mo behind it. Kasi nakaposturing, what do you mention? Anong pagtingin mo sa amin? Bobo? Human rights genocide. Ang genocide iha, pareha man tayong abogado kung hindi ka gaga. You're just taking into the rank, papahiro ko dyan sa mga NGOs, pati ang human rights. Pakialam ng human rights, 1,000 na matay, puro kriminal, either by the police or killed by the internecine in between and by themselves. At yung iba, pinatay yun. Kagaya ko, kung namatayan ako ng anak, nasaksak, o na-rape ang anak ko, o nalunglong sa druga ang anak ko, at bikaka na lang dyan, mabuntis, araw-araw, anak na. I cannot accept that. And as president, I would never accept that. Human rights, pakialaman ninyo, ina kayong mga human rights, in the Middle East, it's bombing every day. It's killing thousands of people. They are even bombing hospitals. I have not heard the president of the UN or anybody in that shit thing na nanagreklamo. Ang Thaksin, when he was premier of Thailand, he killed 3,000 people in one day. All drugs. Wala akong narinig nitong huwag kang kayo magpapit. Do not, you know, guys in the UN, do not. If you want to investigate, go ahead. Punta kayo dito, kay turuan ko kayo. I'll give you the finer points of law. What could you? Genocide. Genocide is you kill indiscriminately. Because of a race, by reason of race or creed, religion. We are fighting criminals here, destroying the lives of people. Destroying my country. When my country is at stake, do not fuck with me. That's what I'm telling them. Any question? So you just sit down there. If you're comfortable sitting down, just sit down there. You look more beautiful, just relax there.
Sir, yung sinasabi nyo kanina na Lady Crusader, pinainvestigan ba natin ito?
Yes, we have been also tailing her. He said, follow me. I'm not only following her. I've been listening to you, my lady. I'm not only following you. I'm hot on your trails. Well, kung magsabi ka na killer itong mga taguberno, which is really an insult, so you get an insult also. You get to impute, attribute a lie to us, then I'll tell the public about the truth of you. You know, what you can do, I can do 10 times better. Parang gano'n yan. I will produce to you a tape. Many years ago, there is this crusading lady of the human rights went to the vow. Just before entering the room where there was this investigation, he blurted out in front. Pag nakakita ng media, umiikot ang muka eh. Nag-iiba ang anyo. Totoo. Muna, puntahan mo ngayon. Abangan mo. Paglabas niyan. Pag nakita yung glaring lights, tapos yung cameras, nag-iiba ang anyo ng akala niya, she is the conscience of the country. And she blurts, I will prove to you in this investigation that Duterte is connected with the DDS, Davao Death Squad. Siya yung head. Putang ina mo, hanggang ngayon naghihintay ako niyan. But at that time, you libeled me, you slandered me. I kept quiet because you are a lady. Sumubra ka na, well, maybe you won on the platform of human rights. Ang bugok namang Pilipino, naniwala sa iyo. Yung bumoto lang rin sa iyo. Hindi naman lahat eh.
Susan Enriquez from GMA 7. Sir, can you name the lady government official?
I can, because, you know, it's a part of my duty. Okay man ako. You want to know the name? Dilima.
Mr. President, pwede pong follow-up. Meron po kayong, meron kanina sa isang newspaper na sinasabi na meron, yung meron pa kayong mga susunod na listahan.
Yes.
Ng mga
yes.
narco-politics.
Many of them still policemen and judges. You know, if the rule is not enforced against everyone, it should not. None at all. Na-late lang ang validation because, you know, you, tama ang Supreme Court. You destroy permanently the reputation of the person. But the problem is, I have a duty to perform. I am not a civilian in the true sense of the word. I am a president whose sworn duty is to protect the people of the Philippines. The higher interest of public service. Kuha ninyo yan? Okay. Pag nakuha ninyo yan, alam na ninyo. Because kayo mismo, tinatanong mo na ngayon, so what does that question mean? You are saying that since I signed the freedom of information, I am now duty-bound to answer your question. If there are some or still many, I have to tell you the truth. I cannot lie because it is not the business of a president to lie to the public.
Mr. President, pwede niyo na pong pangalanan yung iba pa.
Eh, hindi ko memorize. Ang nandito
yung ilan
lang,
po lang, si sir. Yung iba lang, yun nasa lista, yun nasa immediate, ano radar nyo lang na.
Wala ako dito. Baka andito si, pero hindi man ito sir, si Vice Admiral Cesar Tacad. The officers and men of the armed forces, they cannot be the, wala akong listahan, ma'am. But maybe in the fullness of God's time, we would be able to, I will be able to furnish the Republic of the Philippines. At least the people, the names of the names of the people who are doing a great disservice. Kumbaga, ika nga sa Middle Ages yon, that is treason. Tinalikuran mo yung bayan mo. That I cannot forgive you, especially the police and the judges and the, ewan ko itong prosecutors. Iba ang listahan ng prosecutors. Eh.
So, sabihin, sir, you will still announce even yung names of the judges given the,
yes.
What happened po with CJ Sereno?
Well, I can have a choice. I can send the list to the Supreme Court insofar as the judges are concerned. Okay? Fine with me. Na bahala na siya kung tanungin siya doon, who are the names of the judges? Siya na, dito, because executive department, I myself signed an executive order. So kung ano yung listahan dumating sa akin, galing confidential from the military and the police, at that point to me, that is really confidential secret. Huwag mo unahan ang presidente. But when it comes to me, it becomes public property. So now you can ask me, pursuant to your executive order, are you now willing to let go of the names? Of course. I'm willing. I should be willing.
Kailan niyo po papangalanan ito?
Pasyahin ko muna yung sapatos ko kasi mapagbalik ko. Dumi, maputik doon sa ginano doon, nagulan.
Pero what's happening right now, sir?
What's happening right now is I am warning everybody. I am warning the police to stop. Stop it. Lahat and everybody connected with government. Do not use your, it cannot save you. Na doon sa taxes, sabi ng mga, I just was listening to the TV last night, and said there were comments by some business men that should I exercise restraint. Sabi ko nga, tax evader. How can you exercise restraint kung hindi ka cheating government? Wala man akong sinabing ordinary man. You know, they don't listen to my words. Kasi actually, pag magbigay ako ng parang statement, akala nila, I'm very specific, cheaters and tax evaders. So, why would now I exercise restraint? How can now I help government correct the aberration in the lack of taxes if I just restrained myself from doing so? It is not my duty to keep secrets. So the best way now for the businessman, kung may atraso ka, bayaran mo. Online, it will close permanently. Itong online, sinabi ko kay Ong Pin and the rest of the guys there, you are not paying taxes there. At saka, ang Bingo, which used to be found in the malls only, at yung recreation centers ng mga retirees, ng mga matatanda na parlor games. Ang Bingo is purely parlor games. Na kung ang Pagcor allowed it now as a legit gambling, for as long as taxes are paid, okay lang ako. But in every barangay now dito sa Dewey Boulevard and everywhere else, nandyan yung online. Hindi ko malaman kung sino nag-online dito sa Pilipinas ngayon. And hindi ko alam kung magkano ang taxes na pupunta sa gobyerno. So you must be taking me for an idiot. You have been using this kind of scheme. Labas na sa casino, puro online sa Dewey Boulevard, every building there, including sa likod. Yung sari-sari store may online. And so there is a proliferation of gambling everywhere. Tapos only to benefit a few. Itong pang mga business mo siya. Oh, Duterte should make clear who are the oligarchs. Anak ng puta. Kung hindi ka ba talaga bingi pati buta, bulag. Kaya sa mga harap mo, every meeting nyo dyan pa, sigarilyo lang kayo pa, inom-inom. You're playing with online and every gambling in this country and in it's only good for the rich. Kapital nila laway lang. Ano kapital nila? It's because they know the powerful. They know that in the higher echelons of government, pare, ito maganda ito. Meron ka dito sa akin. Ito, ayoko lang magsabi ayoko magpahiro. Pero kung ganyan lang naman ibigay mo sa akin, mahal ako. I can be bought, but you have to start with trillion. Halos one-fourth ng gross national product natin.
Hi, sir. Good afternoon. I'm Bing Abadan from the Daily Manila Shimbun. Sir, ikailan po ninyo plano ilabas yung mga listahan ng mga metro mayors na involved sa drugs? At sinasabi nila, sir, na bakit po nakabalik pa si Mayor Espinosa sa pagka-mayor despite na malaking droga?
Hindi ka tayo nakakaintindihan yan eh. Every time there's a group of media, I try to explain everywhere. This is drugs, okay? Ito droga to. Bitawan ko yan, dito ako mag-grade ka. He was placed there before we entered this room. Pero akin yan. Okay yan? Yung baril mo. Police. Kunin ko. Sabihin ko, hinawakan ko yan ng limang araw. That's illegal possession of firearm. Sinauli ko. So yun sa police. Kanya man yan. Hinaram ko nga, pero sinauli ko naman sa kanya. Instant crime ang tawag niyan.
Thank you, sir.
You must be in a position. Shabu factory, Nandiyan ako sa labas. Hindi mo ako nakita nagluluto. I was inside the sealed warehouse. Wala, nag-stumble ako dito. Bakit? Ano bang pakialam ko dyan? So, yung akin, hindi ko sabihin na huli ko yan. Yung si Espinosa sa bahay. Ano sabihin niya? Because it is his house. Then, by in all probability, you must be the owner of the thing inside your house. But still, you have to prove it. So, sabihin niya, nilagay lang yan dyan eh. That is why, dito ako, huwag mo akong bulahin. Pag drug lord ka kagaya ni Espinosa, sabi ko, hindi kita mahuli, pero if you niloloko mo ako, pinangalanan na kita, putang ina mo, papatayin talaga kita. Tandaan ninyo yan. Mayor ka, sinabi ko na drug lord ka, tapos maglaro ka pa rin, gamit mo lang ng... Pag nakikinig ako, nag-intercept ako ng ano mo, bawal yan sa batas. Hindi ko naman ibibigay sa inyo yan. Pero pag ganun, niloko mo kayang mayor na saan yung lugar yun? Albuera? Ikaw, Mayor Espinosa, huwag ka talagang magkamali. Puntahan kita doon. Maybe I will, in front doon sa plaza, I will hang you. Hulihin ninyo ako? O, wag ngayon. Hindi mo man ako mahuli ngayon. Ipabugbog kita dyan sa, yan o. Tigas yan. Si Sophia. Hulihin mo ako pagkatapos pagka-mayor ko. Pero kung ikaw ang witness, isali na rin kita. Para pagkatapos ko, wala na mag-witness. Eh, gusto ninyo ganun eh. Ngayon, ito, larong walang hiya to. Laro talaga ito nga. Pero sa totoo lang, ni walang hiya ninyo, inabuso ninyo ang Pilipino. Kaya gusto ninyo ganun na laro. Mabuti na lang, umabot kayo ng 24 oras. Kaya pag hindi, sabihin ko talaga, basukahin mo. Hindi madala ang Pilipinas. Ilang presidente na kasi, sige warning, tapos ganun, iluloko lang ninyo eh. Eh, huwag mo ninyo akong lukuhin.
Sir?
Kasi ako, tapat naman ako nung sinabi ko na iboto ninyo ako kasi mabait ako. Huwag lang ninyo akong lukuhin. Luko-luko pa naman ako.
Sir, ano pong benefits ng government na ibibigay po kay PO3 Darwin Espaliato?
Well, I almost forgot it. I'm sorry. But we are helping the family, expenses and everything. They will get from my social fund $250,000. I will deliver the money in about a week. Then we will answer for all of the expenses. And ang anak niya, which is really the worry now of the mother, sabi namin, until he finishes college. Schooler. And maybe next year I can offer the same to all living or dead. Lahat ng sundalo, pati police, ang kanilang mga anak, libre na sa edukasyon. Pag may nahuli pa ako na police na kasi walang pang-enroll.
Mayor President.
Bahala kita sa kanyon dyan sa Krami.
Hi, sir. Pierre Renato from Rappler. Sir, three questions. First, do you plan to attend the burial of President Marcos? And second, sir, ano po yung ginagawa ng administrasyon niyo to tackle, sir, the mysterious summary killings of possibly innocent individuals? Like, sir, for example, may scholar po na namatay kasi binaril po siya ng hitman and wala naman siyang record of drugs drug involvement. How about, sir, these innocent who were killed by hitmen, and have there been any investigations? Because that
guy
also is a crime. Sir, a scholar po from, I think, Leyte. Sir, marami po eh, like a girl in a jeep who was killed.
Maniwala ka pala.
Sir, meron po talaga. It's recorded. It's in the news.
Unless he is your husband or your samang sabay, maniwala sa iyo. You know that, do not take it. Siyempre, lahat na matay, wala. Wala yan. Baski ako sa nanay ko noon. Ninakaw ko yung lahat ng pera niya. Hanggang ngayon, namatay na lang nanay ko. Hindi talaga ako nag-adbitar.
Sir, pinatay po sila ng mga hitmen wala naman po silang ginawang...
Well, I said, it does not mean that he was not a drug. Look, if a guy dies, it does not follow that he was killed by the police. What would be the stupid police be killing an innocent man? Unless you want trouble for yourself.
Sir, is your administration taking seriously the fact that these crimes are also happening aside from drugs?
Well, I said, you cannot compare one killing to the other. There's always been, as a matter of fact, mas marami ang patay kay Aquino noon kaysa akin to date. Sa aming first, look at the statistics, and I can bet you, hindi basta patay na lang na yun, patay-patay na matay dyan ng Advance Almoranas. Kami pa ang may kasalanan, cancer na yan, pag-advance.
Pero sir, hindi niyo po investigate, kahit
investigate? We will investigate. That is the job of the police. As a matter of fact, even during the encounter someone dies, I have told the police that let it be investigated by EAS or the DCIDG, not from the investigators of the precinct where you are assigned. That would not be fair. Then there's bound to be a collusion somewhere there.
Sir, how about yung first question, sir? Yung will you attend Marcos burial?
Wala pang date eh.
Pero sir, do you plan to if there's a date? Once the date is finalized?
Lumapit ka nga dito. Hindi kita naririnig eh.
Sir, may mic na
ako. If I'm in good health and I am there's no pressing water to attend to, I might. But I would just like to emphasize to everybody. I allowed the burial of Marcos because it is the law. He was a soldier. He said that he was not a hero. Fine. I admit it. At this time, I'm not privy to any of the medals there, or I have not seen it. But he was a hero. And even if he just fired one shot against a Japanese, as a soldier, he is qualified. He is not a hero, fine. But he was a president, and nobody can deny that. It does not mean the following are eligible to be buried there. Presidents, except those who are accused of being a despot somewhere in there. Wala, a president. Sure. Kaya ako, mamatay bukas. Baski ayaw ninyo lahat dito. But, ako. Abi, 24 hours, burn me. Crematory.
Sir, third question, last na, for me. Sir, you will be visiting the Laos for the ASEAN Summit. You will accept the hosting responsibilities in September. Do you also plan to bring up the South China Sea, West Philippine Sea issue in ASEAN? And do you plan to ask for their help?
No, I will only bring the issue when we are together face to face.
With China, sir?
Yes, because if you quarrel with them now and you claim sovereignty, make noise here and there, they might not just even want to talk. So Ramos is there paving the way for the good offices of anybody or any other country. But, you know, we maintain good relations with China. Now, let us create an environment where we can sit down and talk directly. Then that is the time that I would say. We proceed from this. Eh kung awayin mo nga, sabi niya, ayaw ko makipag-away, ayaw ko makipagsalita sa inyo. Bahala kayo sa buhay ninyo. Can we do anything? Wala man tayong magawa. Can we declare war? It is not an option. And I would not be stupid to do that. It could only be a massacre for all. Maybe many for us, some of them, but still war is not an option nowadays. Maganda yung damit mo na green, bagay sa iyo. Kaibigan mong kami nito ni Pia. Ako nga tigalibre sa kanya kung matumba na yan. One time, she was really down on the road. I had to push everybody to get there. Liar ka man.
Wala.
Dito? If you are asking for Estrada, dito si Calixto, wala. Wala pa. Pero wala. Until kung mayroon, may maglabas na ano, sabi ko nga, it is not my duty withhold. Kita mo ngayon, right now you are actually exercising that right given to you by the of FOI that I signed. So how can I renege on that signature? Yes.
Ngayon, pinangalanan nyo yung senador na nasa listahan. And
wala sa listahan.
Wala sa listahan.
No, wala sa listahan. Okay. Ibang ano ko, but, immorality ang na yun ba yun? Diyan na naman tayo. Diyan tayo madimanda. Ikaw
but,
tuluhin mo dyan.
Sir, how far can you go with this war with the
I will go until I am satisfied that the interest of my country is fully protected. None, except that I said, when the time comes, when now I realize that the country is safe from the drug menace problem.
And how many are we targeting, sir, in this campaign?
It will go on until the last day of my term, if need be.
The exact figure, sir, of how many personalities are we targeting? No exact
well,
list.
As we go along, there will be more because itong drugs is, I said, addicting and hindi ba siya nakikinig? Iba siya. Iba siya sa lahat.
Congressman or
wala, isa lang
lawmakers, wala?
Wala masyado.
Wala.
Alam mo mga bright, hindi naman papasok kasi nang, I mean, if you're a politician and you protect, you must be crazy. You make money out of, I said, of the bones of your countrymen. Bakit mo gawin yan? Karaming negosyo. Kaya nga sa mga magkasala na kayo ng magkasala. Smuggling one motorcycle, gana. Magkasala na lang kayo kung ano-mano, squatting, padaan na lang natin sa korte. Pero huwag kayong maglaro dito kasi madumi ito. Binibigay ko talaga sa kanyang madumi. Kasi alam nila, hindi mo, sabihin nung mayor ni Esmina, hindi man niya ako nahuli. Yung nahuli sa Cebu, hindi man sa akin yon. So the case fails. O, huwag kang magkumpiyansa sa mayor. Hindi kita palulusutin. May Cebu ka o wala. And then you continue to... Hindi kita papalusutin. Tahan kita yan. Bahay mo si Pa. Yan kita sa publiko. Yeah, I think so. One of them sa Surigao yan. I really would not want to speculate kasi yan ang video bawal kasi you put everybody under the shadow of suspicion. Yan ang medyo hindi maganda. But naming them publicly is good. But when you try to spawn you cast a doubt sa mukhang hindi maganda. Tayo na lang natin, ha? So, kunting tiis na lang, ma'am. Kasi ikaw, nalamig ka na dahil sa gilig na gilig ka na.
Hindi, sir. Yung second list, can we assure na this one will be quote-unquote cleaner than the first one? Wala na yung mga patay?
No. You, that is, kaya kayo nagkamali dyan eh. Pinasok ng national computer yan. Okay, sa anti-drug. Lahat na patay o buhay, sinali ko para malaman ng tao na yung pinagsuspitsahan nila noon, tama, they were right all along. Sabi ko nga sa kanila, sir, i-resign namin itong patay. No. Do not do that. Make a complete list sa disclosure natin. Para kay kagaya ng ibang judge, napaalis na, nag-retire na, malaman natin na all along pala, itong gagong tong huwis na ito, konektado sa laro ng droga. Doon nagkaano, sabi na, how? Madali yan. Ikaw judge, ako may kaibigan. Ikaw ang nag-handle ng ano. Pasok yung kaibigan. Judge, pwede ba? Hindi ba? Kunti mo lang kaya yan. Tatlong sase lang. Padre, tatlong sase lang. Palusutin mo. Bigayan yan. Semanal ko, ikaw meron dyan, tawagan mo. Ganon ang human being. The human frailty. Ang eroplanong sakyan ko, ma'am, wala na, natuyo na yung... Kanina pa kasi nag-andar yung makina. Sabi ko, mag-alis na ako, painitin mo lang. Ngayon, nag-overheat daw, wala na akong masakyan. Ako? I would just say, I'm trying my very best, period. I do not claim any great success, maybe failures here and there, but I would make the assessment na ginagawa ko lahat ko sa trabaho ko because I'm paid for it. That's why I get the highest salary in this government. Bayad ako. So, tatrabaho ako. I'm paid and I work. I got elected and I give to the people what they want. They want a graft-free government, makukuha nila, makukuha ninyo. Oh. Drug-free, graft-free. Well, I would say, nandito ako because if not, I would not be standing here before you.
Okay, last question.
Sige, sir.
Sir, good afternoon, Mr. President.
Yes.
Vice President Lenny Robredo, in her report, said that she plans to talk to you regarding your opposition in the burial of former President Marcos. Look, any comment on this, sir?
My oath of office says to enforce the laws of the land. Here is a family whose father or husband was a former soldier. Maybe not true that he was a hero. I will grant you that. But he was a president. And he wants to be buried. And the law says they should be, they should be buried there. And that is my oath of office. Whether it is really to the liking of the majority of the Filipinos, or whether they find me obnoxious for allowing it, that is the law. And I'm sorry to say that we have to enforce the law. Now, there are planned demonstrations and protests. Well, this is what I would say to them. Just coordinate with the traffic people so that your right, your constitutional right to protest is equally shared by the constitutional right of others to use their streets. So we can plan something like occupying, give us notice in advance so we can reconfigure the traffic for the day, and you'll have the unbridled, unhampered, undisturbed protest that you like. There will be no policemen, there will be no soldiers. You have the streets. If you want to protest one day, fine. 2 days, fine. 3 days, fine. 1 month, fine. And I will declare a holiday throughout the country.
Follow up, Mr. President. Recently also, a group filed a petition at the Supreme Court. In the event of a decision or a TRO issued by Supreme Court, would that change your decision, sir?
TRO to restrain? Restraining yes. order?
Yes, sir. There's a group of or organization against the burial that filed a petition at the Supreme Court. In the event of a TRO, would that change your decision, sir?
I wouldn't want to speculate, actually. I would not want to preempt the court. You can discuss it. It's already sub judice. But just short of blurting out my position on the matter, I would rather that I would just wait for. I may open myself. I'm a lawyer, so I better watch out. But I would follow what the highest court of the land would order us.
Thank you,
that's
sir.
That's the rule of law.
Thank you, Paul.
Thank you.
Thank you,
sir. Hindi ba siya nagpasalamat?